Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 5.53 that is taken from chapter number 5, Analysis and Design of Beam for Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by Beer and Johnston, 6th edition. So statement is determine the equation of shear and bending moment curve for the beam and loading shown, and in part B, maximum absolute value of bending moment in the beam. So you can see this is a cantilever beam AB having fixed support at point B, and there is a distributed load having function W naught into cos of pi by 2 x by L, where x is any distance from this point A where you want to find the magnitude of this W. So let's start with the solution. The first step for determining the equation of shear and bending moment is that we know that shear force dv by dx is equal to minus w, which is distributed load. So, and this minus w, and we will replace this w with this. So, w naught cos of pi x over 2l. So, from here we will get dv is equal to minus w naught cos of pi x over 2l into dx. If you integrate on both sides, you will get this shear force will be equal to integral of minus W naught cos of pi x over 2L into dx. And we know that integral of cos of AX is equal to 1 over 2 sine of AX plus C, where here you can see A is equal to pi by 2L. So if I use this formula, so it will be W naught into 1 over A. So 1 over A is actually 1 over pi over 2L into sine of A, which is pi over 2L into X plus C1. This will be your shear force. And V will be equal to minus W naught 2L over pi into sine of pi x over 2L plus C1. That this is your equation number 1. Now for bending moment, we know that dm over dx is equal to shear force. So from here dm is equal to v into dx. So integrate it on both sides. I will write it. Integrate it on both sides. So what we will get is that we will get this moment will be equal to integral of V is how much? V is this one. V is this one. You can see this is the equation of shear force, which will be equal to minus 2W naught L over pi sine of pi x over 2L plus C1 into dx. And when you integrate it, it will be integral of minus 2W naught L over pi sine of pi x over 2L into dx plus C1 into integral of C1 into dx. So further simplifying it, it will be equal to minus 2 W naught L over pi, and you can see integral of sine of AX, where you can see that this pi over 2L is let A, clear, as already mentioned over here. So it will be equal to minus 1 over A. So I will write it minus 1 over A. A is pi over 2L into sine of, sorry, cos of pi x over 2L plus C2, and C1, integral of C1 into dx is C1x. Okay, further simplifying it, this moment will become equal to plus 4W naught L square over pi square into cos of pi x over 2L plus C1x plus C2. This is your equation number 2 for the bending moment. Now, this C1 and C2 are unknown constant of integration and can be obtained by using boundary condition. Boundary conditions. So what are these boundary conditions? I will write one by one for this cantilever beam. So at x is equal to 0, we have shear force is equal to 0. Let me show you. Here you can see at x is equal to 0, shear force is equal to 0 because there will be no shear force at the end. Clear? So put it in equation number 1. Put in equation number 1. So when you put it in equation number 1, you will see that x is equal to 0, sine of 0 is 0. So this term, whole term will be 0 and v is 0. For at x is equal to 0, shear force is equal to 0, it means that C1 is equal to 0. So I can write it over here, C1 is equal to 0. Now for the second boundary condition is that at x is equal to 0, we have moment is also equal to 0. So here at free end, the shear force is 0 and moment is again also 0. This is for the cantilever beam. Okay, now what we will do is that put in equation number 2. So when you put it in equation 2, so 0, this is your equation number 2. So 0 is equal to 4W naught L square over pi square into cos of pi, and x will replace with 0. So pi into 0 divided by 2L plus C1 into 0. C1 is again 0. So this will be also 0 and C2. Okay, so cos of 0 is 1. So we will get 0 is equal to 4 over pi naught L square over pi square plus C2. And from here we will get C2 is equal to minus 4 W naught L square over pi square. Now you have both the value of C1 and C2. So what you will do is that put C1 in equation number 1. Where is equation number 1? This is your equation number 1. So you will get V is equal to minus W naught minus 2 W naught L over pi sine of pi X over 2 L, and C1 is equal to 0. So this will be your shear force equation, and this is equation number 3, is required shear force equation for the beam and loading shown. For bending moment, put C1 and C2 in equation number 2. This is again, you can see equation number 2. So you will get moment will be 4W naught L square over pi square into cos of pi X over 2L. C1 is 0, so C1 into X is 0 plus C2 is minus 4 W naught L square over pi square. Now if you take this minus 4 W naught L square over pi square common from this, so you will get here that it will be minus cos of pi X over 2L, the first term here, plus this will be 1. And when you multiply it with this, you will see that you will get this. And when you multiply it with this, you can see you will get this. So, okay. So, this moment will be equal to, I will write the final equation, minus 4W naught L square over pi square into 1 minus cos of pi X over 2 L. And this is equation number 4, is required bending moment equation. Okay. Now, in second part, we have been asked to find the maximum absolute value of bending moment in the beam. So, what we will do is that at x is equal to L, since it is cantilever beam, so maximum bending moment will be at the fixed end. So, I will write it, put x is equal to L in equation number 4. Equation 4 was moment is equal to minus 4 L square W naught over pi square into 1 minus cos of pi x over 2 L. Let me show you. You can see this is equation number 4. So put x is equal to L. So moment is equal to minus 4 L naught W L square over L square W naught over pi square into 1 minus cos of pi L divided by 2 L. Okay. So this L will cancel and we will get minus 4 L square W naught over pi square into 1 minus cos of pi by 2. And we know that cos of pi by 2 is equal to 0. So what we will get is this term will be 0 and we will get minus 4 W naught L square over pi square. That will be the maximum bending moment. And since we have been asked to find maximum absolute value of bending moment, so I will take mod, so this will be the maximum absolute bending moment, that is minus 4 W naught L square over pi square, which will give you 4 W naught L square over pi square is the maximum absolute value of bending moment. And that is the answer of our second part. So this was all about this problem 5.53. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. All these problems from 5.50 to 5.56 are done on a request of one of the subscriber who requested to explain this problem. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned. Thank you for watching.